Tony Autumn Fishing Show. Now, a lot of you guys out there I know enjoy drop shot fishing for perch. It's very popular, but you know what? It's not really different. They used to use what they call drop minnow tackle 100 years ago. It was what was used then. It worked. What's different? Nothing really different about it, you know? Fishing seems to go in sort of 25-year cycles. Another generation comes along and they think, whoa, this is all new, we're new. No, it's not new. It's old. It might have changed a slightly different technique, tackle, bait, lure. With technology comes new plastic, new latex, new rubbers. What about new lobworms? Not making any more of those, are they? Get out there with a fork, dig yourself some lobworms, and you can actually do the same thing, drop shot fishing, but in coloured water when lures aren't great, your fish can't see them, but in coloured water what comes into its own, the bait for perch is lobworm. So I figured I'm going to try the Graham Pullen drop baiting, drop lobbing, what am I going to call it? I don't know. Did it work? I went out with a little camera. It's going to be a bit of wind noise in there because only me on my own, a little pocket camera balanced on a rock. Check it out, guys. I'm definitely doing it again. This is how I adapt with my tackle.
Okay, here's what I've got. I've got the swan shot there. I've got that loose length of line above there so that I can slide down. There's my hook. And it's hanging just off there, straight, just the same as a drop shot with the lures, but I'm going to be using one of these. Monsieur le lobworm. But I'm not hooking it right through the head, I'm going to hook him just here. That way, I've got a bit of movement above the hook, just above the eye of the hook. Not, I can't pop it over the eye of the hook, don't forget, because the line's touching. It's touching the main line. Just going to thread it up most of the shank, and then leave it like that. Do you see the hooks there? And I'm going to get a bit of movement up here, and obviously I'm going to get twisting and moving there. We'll give it a go and see if my theory actually produces anything, especially a nice half-pound perch. Believe it or not, first cast drop baiting, my new technique of drop baiting with lobworm. I've hooked up a really good fish. Eat your heart out, Mike. Look at this. It's the new, totally awesome Graham Pullen technique of drop baiting. What a fish. Airplane deal. What, every time I make a film anywhere on my own, there's a chainsaw, a motorbike, or an aeroplane. Guys, look at this. A really nice chub. Small stream fishing, jungle fishing, first cast drop baiting. I almost can't believe it myself, to be honest. I felt a bump, and I thought that's a perch. There's the worm straight on the edge. Just bump, 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 jiggle, jiggle, jiggle. Come out, hook. Hook's out. There's my shot, just down the end, there's my shot. Well, he's not 3 pounds, 2.5 pounds, I dare say. But, fish, first time out, on the old skip spinning rod, straight over the skip. Well worth digging the worms for, guys.
And from that chub, gave me the confidence to move swims. There is a perch. So that is the target species, and you can see he's absolutely mullered that worm on the end there. Now I'm only using a very, very light, tiny little spinning rod. It is $4.99 from an American supermarket. You do not need special drop shotting rods or anything like that. It's absolute twaddle. It's what's happening at the other end of the line that matters. And if you're getting a little perch like this, let's face it, guys, it's what it's about. It's fun. It's happiness time for people. And you can see here, here's my shot. There's a shot. And you can see I've still got a tag in. I can slide that shot up and down the line to change depths. Just untangle the worm. Okay, so this is my first rig. I alter it in the second time, but a different one. But this is my first attempt. You can rehook that worm, and there you go. I love fishing like this. It's recycling. I watch the cast pop right in that corner by that bush. That is a classic far bank shelf drop off on this tiny, it's only a small river, very small river as you can see. And what you do is just let it sink to the bottom. It's not a big drop shot weight. All it is just a swan shot. Now you can put two swan shot on if you want. It give you extra bit of casting weight and an extra bit of sinking weight. Depends on the current, but as you can see by those leaves on the top, barely moving across the surface. It's obviously a slow flowing river in this section, which is great for perch. And then just jiggle the top. Once it's settled on the bottom, just give them a few tweaks like this, possibly not as much as you would do with a lure, bang, they're on. And the advantage with this is if you get a bang or a take and a perch is pulling at the tail of the worm, if you just pause a second or two, whereas if you pause with a rubber lure, it stops the action, doesn't it? It stops all that movement. They're just going to spit it out. They probably won't take it, which is hanging there, a lump of plastic in the water. But guys, if you're using this worm technique, then they've got the smell, they've got the taste, and we all know what perch think of earthworms, and especially lobworms. They absolutely love them. So I think this method actually has an advantage over rubber lures. Maybe, you know, in clear water it doesn't work the same, but here you go. Technical, a very highly technical bait tub here. Yes, it's an old, well, it's not a jam jar, it's a sandwich spread jar. We used to punch holes in the top, and I use that because it keeps a nice constant temperature, like plastic, and heat up and put the worms off and perhaps kill them in the summer. So you can use a glass jar, just punch some holes in the top, you know, just stab it, get a few holes in the top of the tin lid, and it'll still work. Old school, I know, but here we go, guys, it's working. Thread that worm up there, but leave a little tag end at the top. Just a little cast out. Now, just check the dark shadow line in the back there on the far bank. There's a bit of current coming through just there. You might just have been able to see where the shot hit the water. I run the line across my fingers. So here we go again. So you know exactly how to check out a good perch swim. The current you can just see in the middle of the river swirling. That's the main flow. They're unlikely to be in that. Where they're going to be are where those leaves are over in the back in that slightly slack, just on the edge of that faster current. Now, it's little tips like that that will put you in the kill zone for perch, and that is with lures or bait. It makes no difference. You need to get that right current. The perch are not like, let's say, barbel or dace. They are not going to thrive in a raging torrent of a fast current. They like to be on the edge, just on the sort of periphery, and that's the second perch I've had there on the same worm. It's recycling, Graham Pullen style. And knowing Graham Pullen, if I get that worm back, it's going to go out again.
Well, I've had about 15 perch now. Better make that 16 perch. So the method works. Just getting dust. I'm going to keep moving. And that nice big chub. The method works. Give it a go. I'll change it. I'm going to change it from drop baiting to drop lobbing. And you just got to, or when you get the take, when you first get bump it and you feel the take, just pause for a second just to let them get that tail of the worm into their mouth and get to the hook. It's a great method. I tell you what, I'm going to be using it again for sure. Guys, it's nearly dark. I've got a really good fish hooked up on this drop lob. I don't know what it is. Could be another chub. There he is. Nice big chub. See if I can get him out for you. There he is. God, this is jungle fishing at its best. Wait till you see this one. It's about 3.5 pounds. I don't know if you've got enough light, guys. I'm going to put it up here. just balance it. You might have enough light, I don't know. Right, there we go, people. A massive chub. Not going to make four, I should think it's about 312. And there, you can see the lobworm's just in the corner of its mouth. Whack-a-doo, I was lucky. It was one last cast into the right spot. Jiggle that, bumped it, twitched it, crash.
After getting those big chub and those perch with the drop lob method, I was back again, obviously. This time, I managed to talk Mike to get rid of his rubber lures and come out with me and at least give it a go. I was that impressed with the method. This is how it went. Well, I've come back to the river after the success of getting those chub. I had to bring Mike down here. I've taken him away from the dark side, all that rubber. Get him away from all that rubber and plastic. And we come down to use the drop lob. Now you can see that what I've left is a bit of an extension there. I've left maybe 2 inches there. And that's just my personal preference. Now I did notice when I did a little bit of drop shotting before on another walk, I think it was up on the Thames, the hook is actually on the line, the hook's touching the line. Now I tried it on a long drop, but when you just pop it to jig it, all it does is move the knot and it leaves the lure in the same place. You don't get that lure action. So I can now see, couldn't see it at the time, but I can see it now, that hook has to be attached to the main line. To, as you twitch the main line, the lure twitches. With this way, I've left about 2 inches just to let them get hold of it a little bit more, and I'm not going to work it quite so violently, just give it a tweak. Anyway, we'll give it a shot. I'm here a bit earlier. Mike's already fishing. Is he going to get lucky with the drop lob, or is he going back to the dark side of the rubber? Mike may be a dyed-in-the-wool, a totally addictive lure fisherman, but trust me, when he got that first bite on a twitch lobworm, he was totally sold. I think he's going to get out of the garden fork and actually dig his poor old dad some worms this time instead of me.
Well, fish on. We're late as usual on the Totally Awesome Fishing Show, but as you can see, the little half a lob there, lobworm, on the drop lob, dad's drop lob technique. I've given it a go. He's finally persuaded me to get off the lures and try a bit of bait.
You've had a few though.
I've had five in about 5 minutes.
So once you've dug your worms up, get some lob worms, you want to put them in some moss like this. Now years ago they used to put them in moss to scour them, allegedly. So they wriggle their way through to the bottom. So when you get your worms, they invariably will be at the bottom of the bait tin. There we go. Look at that lovely lot of lob worms there. And as you can see, right into the moss. Now, when years ago, I think it was the Victorians, used to say they scour themselves in moss. Well, I don't know. I think what it is, the moss retains the moisture, because obviously that's why it grows. It's moss. Moss grows in damp areas. So that moisture enables them to live a bit longer. As you can see, I've got some here. You won't even let go of that one. Big, big lobs, and that's just what you want. That's what perch love. I love this drop lob fishing, you know. I've always been what you would politely call me, a meat merchant. I like using bait, so I'm a meat merchant, but it works. This is quite a nice perch. I just came upstream from Mike. I'm gonna swing him up on this tiny little... This is the skip rod, by the way. You can see the bend in the tip up there. Open it up a snap. And a nice perch.
Nice perch.
On the drop rod. Shows you. Now, I had several bumps with that. I did, in fact, think that might be a really big perch. Ouch! Nobody told me they have spines. I did have a couple of bumps, and I did think by the way it was taken that it might actually be a chublet, but it wasn't. So there's a nice perch, and you can see the drop rod works. And I just left about 2 inches there, just 2 inches to give it a bit of movement. And I've got just a single swan shot there. And of course, I can still slide that up and down as you do with those drop shot weights. Easy to unhook, just pop him off like that. Get out there, guys. Get yourself some lobworms. It's so simple. You've still got your fallback of all your lures, your rubber lures, but you can use worms as well. And they're good in coloured water conditions where the lures aren't.
Now you'll see from this second trip out that I've actually adapted my technique. And what I'm doing is I pop that rod tip every now and then, but I'm holding a length of line in my left hand, a little bit of slack, because I can touch ledger, I can feel the worm when it gets hit by perch, I can just drop that slack back to them, and that gives that literally, I say, a 2 second pause to allow it to get it in its jaws, in its mouth, and it doesn't get deep hooked. And also using that little bit of standoff, that 2 inch standoff, I think is actually working even better for me. And you can see there, it's not a throated perch, hasn't taken it deep, it's hooked perfectly, it's ready to go back.
Guys, I was just texting our mate Wayne, who does the boat, he's had a low double cod.
That is, oh my days.
It's big, I thought it was a chub. I've had a bite, had the rod on my arm. I was texting Wayne, he said I've had a low double figure cod. I go, well done mate, we've had some perch. I've got to get it, I'm going to have
the
to jump
down.
The
size of this perch.
And the rod really came out of my arms, I had it tucked under my arm.
That is a nice perch.
Oh, that's a two.
That's a nice perch.
I thought it was a chub, I cannot believe it.
Oh man, look at that perch, man. Worm just on his lip.
Just realised I don't have Wellingtons.
On the
and he's just hooked there.
Oh, on the drop lob.
On the drop lob. That is
beast.
A PB for Graham on the drop lob. So you've got to beat this, guys. You've got to get about a 2.5 pound perch while texting your mate Wayne about his double figure cod. Now what's happening? Wayne's getting a text back with this big perch. What a cracker. I use the French laugh when I get excited. Here's the worm in his mouth. Look, and I know this is good because I can use the worm again. Let's get him unhooked. I'll show him to you properly. Oh, yes, please, ladies. Yes, please. And I thought it was a chub. I can't believe the luck. It just goes to show you. Do you know what I mean? You don't know in fishing what the hell is going to come along. Wayne had been having a slow day out on the boat. Late in the afternoon, the sun's going, I said to Mike, do you know what, I really fancy Wayne's chances out there of getting a cod, and he's coming, he's got a low double and some other fish as well. While I'm texting him away saying, well done, mate, the rod comes out from under my arm, a whacker, a thunder whack of a perch. And you know when the perch get really big, they get that steep head, it really builds up here and you know you've got a good fish. We have no scales, I'll leave it to you YouTubers to tell us what you think it is. We reckon it's probably about 2.5 pounds. It is a really, really super fish on a super day. Drop lobbing, I don't think I'm going to be using rubbers anymore. Of course I will. You want to get Mike?
Yeah.
Here comes the net, which we constantly share amongst the family.
We share all the time. It's probably just over a pound, I'd say. Nice perch though. Dorsals up. And on this ultralight rod, this rod tip is just folded. Absolutely folded over.
Don't go in. Get in, yeah, that's over.
And some brambles. Oh, let's get him unhooked. There we go, there's the old drop
knob.
That's what's left. I'll still use it again. But another nice.
Pound and a quarter.
Pretty nice looking perch.
Yeah. Pound and a quarter at least.
What a great little fish. And they're starting to feed up now, these perch, throughout the winter. And I can see some of them have got a little bit of a belly on them. I know yours had a nice gut on it.
Yeah, they're thickening up a bit now.
It's starting to get a bit bigger. And there's that steep head that you get
the
with ridge. A sort of bigger perch. Yeah, that big head to them. But lovely markings. Really nice markings on this fish. So we've probably only got 1.5 hours of light left, I'd say. It's fading pretty fast. We're kind of beginning of December now. It's fading pretty fast, so we've got only a few. We've only been out, what, two hours?
A bit over an hour, I guess.
A bit over an hour, and we've had some decent fish.
15, 20 perch.
Awesome, let's get this one back and get that worm out again.